Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, why is it that CCLI lyric search seems not to be working anymore on versions of ProPresenter that are ProPresenter 7.11 and older? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if this has ever happened to you, why don't you go ahead and subscribe to this channel so that I can tell you about stuff like this. Click on the little bell icon, etc. And go ahead and like and share this video as well. Could be someone else on your team needs to know this, or in another local church that you've talked to. So normally I go into ProPresenter and I tell you all about stuff. Well, this is something that I don't need to show you, ProPresenter, because it's just a little piece of information that Renewed Vision has made known, but it may have slipped past you. Because one thing they did is they emailed the email address they have on file. Maybe that's not your email address. And maybe it's something that someone else got and meant to tell you about it, or got and said, oh, I don't need to read anything from Renewed Vision, and promptly deleted it. We've been discussing it a lot in the ProPresenter users community as well. So if you're not a member of that, head over there. That's over at TDM.fyi/PPUG. And make sure you answer the questions, and I'll let you in right then and there. I can use those questions to keep spammers out of the group. So,
hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you.
All that to say, what's happening? Well, CCLI, the Church Copyright Licensing International, I think is what CCLI stands for, they changed the API. You may not know what an API is. You don't have to. Basically, it's how different companies and pieces of software interact with one another. So ProPresenter basically goes out to the website for CCLI and says, hey, I need to search for this song. CCLI says, fine, I just need to know, first off, is this someone who has an account with us? And so they check that, and then they do a search for the song. Well, they've changed some stuff recently, and since Renewed Vision is always moving forward, they did not go back into old versions of ProPresenter, which, why would they? They've got, as I'm recording this, a couple of different versions that it works perfectly fine for. The problem is that if you have an older version, it may not work perfectly fine for you. So, what can you do? Well, first off, you could use multitracks. That's a fine way to do it. They've got a lot of stuff there, and multitracks does have the added benefit of having chord charts. So maybe you want to do that. You could also search on their website directly, copy and paste it into ProPresenter. That's another way to do it. You could also upgrade to ProPresenter 7.12 or newer. I think I'm remembering that right, that it's 7.12 and 7.13 as of right now when I'm recording this. So that's another thing to do. So those are kind of your options. If you want it to be like it was before, then you really need to upgrade. If you do that, you'll find that you have an additional capability, and that is the ability to automatically do your reporting, so you don't every few years get a, hey, we want to get a report from you for a certain amount of time. Now, don't worry about that. It can be done automatically. So that is one of the advantages of the new API, is it does real-time reporting, which is more accurate. They have some algorithmic stuff so they don't over-report. And then you can get that done. So that's why it's not working and some of the options you have to get around that problem. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/pro, the number 7, and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Till next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.